So, Olga, so what links these three things, the war in Ukraine, the coup in Burkina Faso, and Yevgeny Prigozhin?
The Wagner Group. They're a Russian private military company, meaning people pay them to fight on their side or train their soldiers.
So, basically, they're mercenaries.
More or less, but with very close links to the Russian state. They have been recently active in Syria, Libya, Central African Republic, Sudan, Mozambique, and most recently in Ukraine, Mali, and allegedly Burkina Faso.
So why are a group of Russian mercenaries so active in Africa?
To understand that, we need to find out a bit more about exactly who Wagner Group are. The group was founded in 2014 by Russian oligarch Yevgeny Prigozhin, something he recently admitted after denying any involvement for many years. Prigozhin is a close ally of the Russian president. In fact, he is known as Putin's chef. He made money with a chain of grocery stores and as a restaurateur. Putin was one of his diners, which led to him running a catering company and securing many government contracts. The Wagner Group has been actively fighting on the Russian side in Ukraine, and Prigozhin has been filmed recruiting for them in Russian prisons. Convicts are allegedly offered pardons in return for their service.
Right, so Wagner Group has quite close links to the Russian state.
Legally, Wagner soldiers are not a part of the Russian army, and thus their activities are not scrutinized in the same way. And the Russian government can deny responsibility for their actions. However, Prigozhin is very close to Putin, and the Wagner Group's leadership is thought to be heavily influenced by the Russian foreign policy goals. They also get a lot of help from Russian Ministry of Defense. And this could explain why they have been so significantly involved in several African countries.
Right, because since 2018, Wagner troops have been engaged in the civil war in the Central African Republic, supporting the president Faustin Touadera. Mali and Burkina Faso have also allegedly sought their assistance. Both countries had two separate coup d'etats in 2022, and all of these coup d'etats were the result of the same thing, the Islamist insurgency in the Sahel region. Thousands of people have died in the conflict between groups of Islamist militants, some linked to Islamic State and some to Al-Qaeda, and the nation's security forces. Successive governments have failed to stem the violence. France, once the colonizer of both Burkina Faso and Mali, was providing military assistance until recently. However, public opinion in the two West African countries turned against them, as people felt they were incapable of halting the violence, and both governments have told France to remove its troops. Instead, they have turned to Wagner.
Okay, so these governments are hoping Wagner will succeed where the French have failed.
Presumably, but so far the results have not been fantastic. Civilian casualties as a result of violence more than doubled last year, according to data from the crisis mapping organization ACLED Info, and the insurgency in the Sahel shows no sign of abating.
So does Wagner and Russia make sense as an ally for these African countries?
Well, Africa has not been as critical of Russia's invasion as the rest of the world. In February 2023, when the UN called a motion to seek the end of the war in Ukraine, two African countries voted against the resolution, Eritrea and Mali. 32 nations abstained, and 14 of these were African. Five African countries did not vote, including Burkina Faso. Also, when Ukrainian President Zelensky spoke to the AU in June 2022, only four heads of state turned up. So by supporting these countries, Russia has a chance of some much-needed international support over Ukraine and some more UN votes in the future, perhaps.
Yes, in fact, this goes beyond just Ukraine. Putin sees the whole world as his chessboard, and he's always attempting to move pieces and control more of the board. He wants influence in Africa as it gives him more power. In the Soviet era, the USSR had a lot of influence among the various communist governments and parties on the continent, and he likes to hear himself in that tradition.
That makes sense. There are also economic incentives for Russia to make allies on the continent. These African countries have some valuable natural resources, including gold and diamonds. And in the Central African Republic, Wagner have been paid with mining concessions for their military assistance. Ghana's president has said that their alleged presence in Burkina Faso is in exchange for a mine.
In Central African Republic, Wagner Group has attempted to control the flow of gold and diamonds. These valuable resources could help Putin survive the economic sanctions Russia faces. We also know that Russia is looking for a market for their weapons. Sanctions have hugely reduced their potential market for exports of their weapons. And these potential West African allies fighting a protracted conflict against insurgents in the Sahel could prove to be good customers.
And it's not only arms that the Russians can provide these countries with.
That's right. Russia provides many different services that can help these countries. For example, they provide leaders with PR skills and electoral advice and strategies to help them maintain power.
It makes sense that they would be seeking those things and seeking new allies. These governments, partnering with Wagner, came to power in military coups. They aren't democratically elected. This loses them allies both on the continent and amongst powers in Europe and North America. Plus, popular opinion in Burkina Faso and Mali has turned against France, and these governments want to break with their former colonial governors. They need new allies, and Russia is seen as a good option. China is another power that has provided them with investment and some support, but they are not prepared to commit military resources, something these countries are able to receive from Wagner. However, as the war in Ukraine takes more and more Russian manpower, it remains to be seen how much of a priority West Africa will be for Russia and whether they have any success in combating the ongoing insurgency, which has been the trigger for these moves.